1, 2, 3. One, two, three. Mic check, mic check. Okay, there we go. Let me slower the music a little bit. It's too loud. Okay, there we go. Well then, let's do this now. I was streaming, but something happened, and now I'm just trying to make it better. Okay, so right now I'm just trying to finish this Loki thing. It's for a friend. She definitely wants it to be done, and it's gonna be awesome. Feel free to comment and whatnot. I'll be here all night. Pretty much like an hour or so.
This feel like my new shit. This feel like my blueprint. This feel like my world finally found the perfect student. This feel like it's supposed to. Found what I've been close to. Slightly out of grasp till I reached out and approached you. I refuse to hide back. Tell my fam I fly back. I could not just sit still. Me, I had to try that.
Give me a second here. There we go.
Wrote a couple hundred songs. Still can't write all of my wrongs. Still just can't get too involved. If my heart's not fully in it, mind's not fully focused. If it don't grasp my attention, foot on the ignition. I just left my home state. Porch is where we grew up. Headed towards my own fate. Fresh graduated. Now they dish to me my own plate. See what you can make, son. Oceans from the lake, son. Pistons to the lake, son. State, son, give it all it takes. You want a legacy to make one. Yeah, it's celebrations. It's saying patience is the way you can make it.
Is there anyone watching? I'm just starting this up again. I had a little problem in the beginning. Oh my God. There we go. Okay, let's do this again. The only bad thing right now is that my pencils didn't load. The thing about Photoshop is that, like, you get like the perfect brushes sets, and then out of nowhere, if it crashes, it just it's hard. It's always about finding the perfect brush set. I'm still working on the sketching part of it. I mean, it's not hard, it's just that I have to like watch it. There we go. It's not a problem that I'm having. This is my first time sketching on Photoshop. Usually what I do is that I sketch on... What I do usually is that I sketch on Adobe Sketch, which I have on my laptop, and then I transfer it. But the problem that I've been having with that is that I want to be able to start making canvases and whatnot, and if you want to make a large canvas, like Adobe Sketchbook automatically makes it by like 11 by 10 or something like that, and I definitely need to make my canvases bigger. So this is going to be 20 by 20, which is not too bad. And I'm hoping that it'll end up nice, mainly because it's for a friend. I think it's for a friend of mine that she's just crazy with Loki, for obvious reasons. Tom Hiddleston being one of them. The thing is that I'm good at sketching faces, like faces that don't have a problem. But then when it comes to such things like wardrobes, I'm like, oh lord. What am I doing? The funny thing about this is that I'm just basically talking to myself. Well, that's for now. You can say this, I'm not a master, like, costume design, but I gotta make this work. Gotta make it work. Let's get back to the face again. The thing about hands that are a little tricky, so you gotta make them so it looks cohesive. Hands are tricky for sure. It's a lot of time to just learn about them. The thing more about this is that what I'm doing with it, okay. So for anyone who follows me and knows how I draw, I'm just doing a rough sketch basically. So when I actually start drawing or painting, because that's where my strong suit is, I know where everything should go, have an idea for it, and be acquainted with the face. Ah, dang it, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. The good thing about drawing stuff like this is that because it's all pixelated, gotta think about it like drawing like in pixels rather than drawing like when you draw physically, like it's a different feeling for sure. Ooh, I love this song. Okay, one thing when you're drawing that most people don't. So, tip for drawing. Drawing tips with John while I'm live streaming. Is that basically when you're doing it, always make sure that when you're grabbing the pencil, some people don't know how to grab the pencil. Like, you gotta, like, be careful with the pencil. You can't see me, so I can show you a lot. But basically, when you're painting or doing a sketch, always be kind to it. Don't grab it like you're writing. Most people, when they write, they like grab their pens like a fist and just start just hammering into it. When you're drawing, it's more about it's a little kinder. Check something real quick. Oh, that's not what I want. Settings, capture cursor, yes. There we go, capturing cursor. I want you guys to see what I'm painting. That's weird. By mistake, apparently, I changed it, so even though, give me a second here. I'm gonna save this. Smell that painting. What happened is that I think I lost the cursor. you guys can't see the cursor where I'm like trying to paint, and that annoys me because then it just means like your guys' eyes are doing more hard work than mine, trying to figure out where I'm sketching at the moment. There we go. So this is gonna come right over here. It's gonna be a little further back. There we go. What I can do is start painting this because I have no idea how I'm gonna paint it. The thing about painting marble characters is that like their design, they have a lot of design. The costume design on these characters are amazing. We were like thought about doing this. They know what they're doing with the characters. When you come to drawing them, you want it to be specific to how you draw them. Definitely gotta like either simplify it or you have to go full blown like custom design when you're drawing them. I have an approximate. I mean, the good thing about this one, there we go. The thing about Loki is that what he wears, it's almost like a full-blown suit. It reminds me of a lot of what Neo wears in The Matrix. It's not exactly like a dress, but it flows like a dress. It just covers his whole body like a dress. So when I'm done with it, I'm coloring it. What I'm going to have to do is find a way how to make the leather pop out. Plus, just between you and me, I'm not gonna draw the whole body. What do you think? I am insane. Interesting. Oh, that's interesting. Dang it. Let me try something different kind of music. Give me a second, guys, here. Let me try some Principle and Luffy hip hop. Oh my god, my Facebook page. Do not see that. There we go. Give me a second here. Because the reason I was just thinking a break a little bit is because basically because of my music that I'm using. YouTube just basically YouTube basically copyrighted the last video I had. They blocked it because of the music I'm playing from Spotify, because they're really careful of copyrights. So it's a sad face. My video was blocked basically because of music. So I had to change my music from what I'm playing on Spotify, which was good, to play something more from there's a live stream from Luffy Hip Hop that you can see in YouTube, which is phenomenal. And hopefully I don't get copyrighted. Because I want people to see me, of course. Thank you. this kind of music so sad. So like I was saying, like just running painting the costume or Loki's costume instead. I think it's interesting how they like make it so even though the costume is simple, they keep it visually appealing by adding this like leather straps to it. Yeah, figure out how I'm gonna draw them once how I'm gonna paint them more selectively. Okay, then down here the picture kind of turns into black, face into black. The thing I'm worried about with this picture that I'm drawing is that the picture itself is a little darker, and my paintings are usually way, like, have a lot of red colors to them. That's how I like to paint. I like to paint with red colors. Muted colors has been, like, not a thing that I've done myself. I'll work with him later. Okay, so I got my first layer right here. We got Loki. Loki for you. Let's start doing the layers. This is gonna be a paint layer. So right now, when you first are drawing, something you gotta always do is draw masks. Mask layers are basically layers where you paint a plain color. And then later you can, like, what I use is I use the select tool to make sure that whatever I'm drawing basically doesn't look bad. Now, something I recommend for sure, you're gonna see what I mean. So, always to keep in mind is that, so now it's a sketch, right? Not too bad for a sketch. But when you're painting, you gotta keep in mind that the colors have to almost like match. A way to get a little around this is by making a background that it's not just pure white. What happens when you paint pure white and then you paint the whole thing, right? So you paint a whole thing and the background is still white, and when you then go ahead in the end, make a background a different color, because, you know, white backgrounds usually it's not something you want to do in your painting to make it look interesting, is that you see the background you chose and the colors you've chosen do not match. So for me to get ahead of that, is that I go ahead and make a gradient background. Simple background of the colors that I want to choose. Now, when I'm choosing a color, I gotta choose a complementary color from the background just so like the main part of it pops out. So let's say Loki has more of a green texture to him. Let's say I make a background, what a color. Give me a second here. Let me just research this. Always pick a complementary color. That way like your background pops up. So anything red is going to complement green. So let me do this. too red. Okay. Okay. Let's freeze it. There we go. So this is what's gonna happen. Whenever I draw something, I will paint accordingly to the background that I have. I won't just paint on a just simple white background, which helps. Maybe a little more blue. Give me a second here. There we go. Have more blending to it. Do it one more time. Boom. There we go. Beautiful. Let's start with a mask layer. So when doing mask layers, let's begin just doing plain colors. So now we're gonna change the brush tool. Then we're gonna pick skin colors. So usually when picking skin colors, always go for the darkest. That's what I do myself. Oh, I think I lost my painting. My reference picture. That's good. Give me a second here, guys. I just lost my reference picture. So whenever picking colors, to basically pick up as mask, always pick select almost like a slight darker color. It's always to paint. I think it's always good to start with darks rather than lights, and start from there. Yeah, pick the hard brush. I do it right now, the hard round. Basically, what we're gonna do is pick colors. They're gonna be like the background colors. Okay. Make sure you have your sketch on top, just for the time being, while you're painting. And this is how I spend my Saturdays. fine. Well, let's start with the face then. Of course. Note, always make sure you're picking the right layer. When you're erasing or doing anything, make sure you're picking the right layer. There we go. This here doesn't matter as much, since I'm gonna just paint the hair over it. But really, let's at least get the skin right. So, let me see. Whenever I paint, what I like to do is I make an extra layer called palette. Basically, I need to limit my colors. Almost like, you know, like when you see in movies where the painter, like Bob Ross, where he had like these limited colors in a little palette. I'm doing the same thing, but I do it in Photoshop, basically, where I pick this color as my base. I know that's gonna be my base color, and whenever I'm picking on colors to blend into the face, I'm always picking from the colors I'm putting over here. That way I'm not going crazy with my colors and getting out of hand, and I'm actually have like some consistency in my picture. So when you're picking colors, you gotta pick at least like two or three different ones according to what you're trying to do. In my case, I'm gonna pick a base color, a bright, a highlight, and then do the same with the opposite, where it's a shadow and a dark shadow. So we're gonna start from here. When you're picking brighter colors, always make sure to go a little on top of the color wheel and get over here. So let's say this is gonna be my highlight color right over here, and I paint here, and then let's go back to my base color and pick something brighter around here, like a brighter skin tone. There we go. And maybe let's go a little brighter here too. Just gonna pick this again. Oh, nope, that's not what I want to do. And then I go a little yellower here, and then pick a little extra bright. So basically when I'm painting, that means that like I'm using this these colors that I've chosen, rather than just picking just colors as crazy and making it all jumbled. Now let's do the shadows. The shadows is the opposite. You go a little redder, and then you go either more saturated and more darker. So around here. Right, that's gonna be good. And then let's just go a little darker. There we go. That's gonna be a hard shadow. Just restrain, yeah. So that way, like this, because it's gonna be my skin palette. Let me just write it over here. It's bright white, or bright color, and press it. Oh no! Chosen the wrong thing. Dang it. Give me a second here. Nothing works. Skin. Palette. Okay. So where do we start? Well, let's start doing some highlights and stuff. What I personally do when I'm doing paintings is that I have a couple brushes that I use specifically for this kind of stuff. There we go. It's a simple brush, 125-2, this one. It's a texture brush. Texture brushes help your painting. I like having like almost traditional art style to it, and it's always nice to have like brushes that have texture to them, because when you're painting traditional style, you have texture to what you're drawing. So it doesn't have to be perfect. It does not have to be perfect at all. That's the thing about it. You don't have to be perfect. It's just basically we're gonna Another thing. Always make sure you're doing things in layers. Don't be like me. There's all this. There we go. Now it's doing another thing under my palette layer. So what you do is this. I duplicate my layer. Mask. And then I go and call it. Let's call it color change. It's not a textbook description of what I'm doing, but it will do. It may know what I'm doing on this case. So basically, the mask is here. When I do, this is why I do need a mask. Select tool. So I select every single part of it. That's the skin, quote unquote. And that way, when I'm drawing it, everything, I'm not drawing over it, I have to erase and make it look clean. It helps it, so as I'm working on it, it looks clean. Now in the color change area, I do what I was doing, which is basically, I'm gonna use that, there we go. I'm gonna use a texture brush and give it somewhat of a texture. It doesn't have to be complicated, it has to be dirty. Get a little dirty. Don't worry about perfection. See, it's like that. And then we blend. Okay. So when you're blending, make sure that you don't blend too much of the texture. You don't want it to look all soft and whatnot. You want it to make it look somewhat, you know, like a painting. It's too small for brush. A second here, let me save this real quick. I know what I did here. I'm new to Photoshop, by the way. What am I have done? Yeah, give me a second here, guys. I can't see the tip of my brushes, which throws me off big time. So, I'm gonna reset all this again. There we go. Now you guys can see my brush. I can see my brush, more importantly. Now I'm blending. It's not to look perfect still. So this is my technique. Oh, missing something. I'm not gonna pick like this exact some colors that a skin that skin the skin tone will have. I can't say it's my style. This is a place, the time that it takes longer time, just making the paint that does the skin look good. I think it's like almost like I was looking at a video recently about a paint. I think it was Proco. They were talking about when you're painting and stuff, to do it like a sculpture. So you're basically sculpting. So you just have to look perfect at the beginning. It just has to look good overall at the end, right? So you start as a mess, and then you work from that mess. I just really hope that my friend likes this, because I'm doing this for her. Todo bien. Me gusta quedando. ¿Qué opinas? Ya, yeah. Estoy haciendo live stream, pero nadie está. Así que no importa. Pero, ya.
Yeah.
Ya. Yeah. ¿Y aparte, cómo están?
No sé, porque
hay muchos. ¿Qué opinas de cómo está el vivo hasta ahora? Probablemente. ¿Dónde? ¿Acaso Steven? Creo que sí. Pues me voy a So I gotta admit a little bit is that this type of music makes me so sad. So you can see, something you can see if anyone's watching is that the whole purpose of me drawing this way is that it's gonna have this almost oil paint-esque look to it. That's exactly, like right now how it is, it's exactly how oil painting looks on physical. Like I said, like I specialize in oil painting, so it does help a lot. The space is gonna take a while for me to finish. Thank you. Something I do right now. It's my trade secret. If something looks good, I think it looks good so far, and I need to work a little bit more on it, just because I'm afraid I'm gonna mess it up. I do a checkpoint. Basically, I duplicate a layer, and I work on top of the layer, just in case I mess it up. I know what's going on. Oh, I see what the problem is. Yo encontré mi propio estilo. ¿Te crees? I'm gonna get a break from this. Oh, I get tired. back to recording. Just had a little break.
This total galaxy, the real deep down you is the whole universe. And it's doing your living organism and all its behavior. It's expressing it as a singer sings a song.